Let's go. We see the hype outside. Hey guys, Golden here, and welcome back to the Fortnite mobile update video. Now guys, today, unfortunately, we have some bad news to share with all of you guys. So basically, as most of you guys probably know from the last video, I gave a tutorial on how you guys can actually get Season 6 on your iOS device with touch controls. Now, as most of you probably have seen, if you haven't seen the last video, go check out the last video. But basically, in the last video, I explained how you guys can get Season 6 on your iOS device with no computer or anything. You can simply go on your iOS device, download the software, and then get Season 6 with touch controls on your iOS device and play the brand new updates. Well, let's just say after I released that video, first off, the servers got absolutely bombarded and there was almost no way you guys could get into a match unless you waited for like up to 2 to 3 hours of waiting time. Not only that, there's also just so many people complaining that the app wasn't working and no one could get it and it was all bugging and stuff, and that's because I made a huge mistake. Now, I'll explain what that mistake was in a little bit, and I'll explain how you guys can fix that mistake and actually get this app back on your iOS device and be able to play this in just a little bit. But first, I want to talk about how this app actually got banned. So most of you probably know, a little bit ago, this app was released for iOS players that would basically let iOS users play Season 6 on their iOS device with no computer, no jailbreak, anything. And basically, the method was really popping off. Everyone in the mobile community was at least trying it. A lot of people didn't like it, but for the most part, it honestly did pretty good. And I don't know if Apple saw that video or if Apple knew about this method somehow, but basically, about 2 days later, the method in order to get this on your device got what is called in the like App Store developer terms, revoked. And revoked basically means that you can no longer get this app onto your device, and it basically occurs to apps that are not actually officially on the App Store, and Apple occasionally revoke these games in order to prevent you from getting them, because obviously they have a lot of protection over their platform and they don't like people using other app stores to get apps. So basically, this app right here actually got what is called revoked. Recyros, which is the app name if you guys did not know, from the platform Zeus, which is pretty much the only way to download this. And basically what revoked means is no one can play the app at all. If you guys can see right here, I'm gonna try loading it up, it's gonna say Recyros Zeus is no longer available. And if you guys try to install it from the Zeus app, I'm not going to do it now, but if you try to install it, basically it would say it's unavailable, it doesn't work, and you can't install it. So basically, the app just got completely banned from iOS devices. But luckily, you guys can say goodbye to Season 3 again, because I have another method on how you guys can get Season 6 back onto your iOS device, which I'll explain in just a little bit later on towards the end of the video, so stay tuned. But I mean, yeah, guys, it does definitely suck that this game literally couldn't even last a day before it got into issues with Apple and got removed from the App Store. The Zeus app store, obviously. So that's kind of unfortunate. Unfortunately, a lot of you guys did not get a chance to play it because of the long queue times and also obviously the issues with installing it now. Now, for those wondering though, the app developers of the Zeus app are working their hardest to try to get this app unrevoked from their app store. So just stay tuned, guys. I promise within time, eventually this app will return to the Zeus app. Now, when is that going to be happening? I really have no idea. Unrevoking an app can take up to a few days to up to a month. So just stay patient, guys. This might take a little bit longer than you guys may expect, but hopefully it does return really quick. But yeah, whenever this app does actually return, there were a lot of things I said wrong in the last tutorial, and I really want to correct everything. I made a pinned comment of it on that video, but I want to make a whole video basically explaining everything that you guys are gonna need to do to reinstall this onto your device whenever it does come back, which hopefully be a little bit soon. Now, first of all, I actually do have the second version of Recyros I got from the IPA file. I'll be teaching you guys how you guys can install this version, but I want to quickly show you guys how you can fix some of the big issues from the last video and the big complaints people are telling me about, and the main one being how you guys can log in, because I made a huge mistake there. So in the last video, I explained how you guys obviously have to use the SpongeBob app here in order to log into this app and log into your Epic Games thing on this app. However, basically I missed a really important step that literally is a game changer, and without it, you can't log into the Epic Games launcher. So whenever this does return, I want to quickly show you guys how you can actually fix my error that I made in the last video. What you guys are gonna have to do is go in the bottom left to hit that little settings icon and then tap on the GeForce Now beta there, and it will now load up this new tab, hit green, continue, relog in with the top right. And once you guys are logged in, you're still going to want to go to the SpongeBob Bikini Bottom app. If you guys want to look up this app again, you can go search it up in the top. So now I'm loading this up. You guys may have a queue, obviously. If you guys did not know, if you don't have this premium membership, you have the queue time in order to get into this app. It kind of sucks. But once you guys are in, you're now going to see this little screen where it's going to say, choose how to sign into your Epic Games account. I'm going to sign in now so you guys can see it. So I'm going to tap on sign in with Epic Games. It's going to go right here. And now, hopefully, if you guys do get another click, you can tap on that. And now, once you guys do click on the email address box, go in the top left, see that little keyboard thing? thing. Tap on that little keyboard, and now you should get your keyboard. You guys can enter in your details or whatever in order to log in. So you guys can see I've now logged into my account right there, and now it is loading in. And you guys can see I'm now in my account. Obviously, it's gonna say access denied. It does say that, guys. Don't worry about it. It should close out of the app automatically. And now you guys should be able to load up Fortnite if you tap on the bottom left, and now open up the normal GeForce, not the beta one. Tap on the GeForce one, and now if you guys load up Fortnite by tapping right here and tapping play, you should now be inside of your Epic Games account. You can play the game normally without any worries there. Now, another huge thing that I want to mention, a lot of you guys are saying, oh, the buttons don't work, or the buttons do the wrong things like emoting and stuff when you press a stare or something. So a huge fix for this, guys, you guys have to tap in the top right. You should see a little eye right there, so tap on that. And now once you guys tap on this, you guys are going to actually want to tap on the controls setup. Go through all of these and make sure you match every single bind that is on this information screen. And once you guys go through all this and, like, you know, bind everything onto your device, once you do all that, you guys should have all your buttons working perfectly fine. So make sure you guys follow this tutorial, because in the last video I only showed my combat bind. So follow all of this and you should be good to go. But yeah, one more thing, guys, you guys actually do have to be on iOS 14 and above in order to play this app. So if you guys have to update your iOS, go do that. And that's the last thing I have to say in terms of things I said wrong in the last video. If you guys have any other issues, join the developers Discord with the link in the description, or join my Discord. But yeah, guys, please just recognize that this is still a public beta, so it's not fully released, and we need your guys' help reporting bugs and stuff. But now, guys, the moment you have all been waiting for: how do I get Rekairos back after it's been revoked from the Zeus App Store? Now, unfortunately, the only way that you guys can get it back onto your device is if you have a PC. But if you guys do have a PC, the method honestly isn't too hard. It's super easy. It's like takes like 2 steps. You guys can get on your device. Not too difficult. But the good news about this version is if you guys use the PC version of getting this, it can never get revoked ever again. So if you guys use a PC to download this, there's no worry of it ever getting revoked. You guys will never have to worry about never having this app on your device, because Apple basically has no control after that, and they can't revoke any games that you installed using an IPA file. But yeah, I say we head right on into the PC tutorial on this situation. So first off, guys, if you guys are going to want to do this, you guys are going to want to head on over to allstore.io. And once you guys are on this website, I'll leave links down below if you guys want to check out all the stuff. All links will be in the description. But basically, once you guys are here, you're going to want to go on download all server for macOS or Windows. In my case, I'm on a Windows PC. I don't know if my specific tutorial will work with Mac user, but you guys can try it. But I would highly recommend looking up a tutorial on how to get all store on your device with a Mac PC, because I don't know if this will really work well with you guys. But assuming you are now on a Windows PC, tap on a download all server for Windows beta. Now you guys should get this all installer.zip file. So obviously you're going to want to tap on that. Now open it with WinRAR if you guys do have that. Ideally, you guys should have WinRAR on your computer. If you don't, I don't know if it'll work with File Explorer, but you guys can try that. But if you guys do not have WinRAR, go to the other link in the description to download WinRAR. But I already use it, so I can do it right here. You should see this little folder that says something like this: setup.exe or all installer.msi. I'm going to tap on setup.exe right there. Now you just want to go on next and all this stuff, and just do next, all that crap. You guys can mess around with settings if you want there. Now, in my case, I actually already do have all server on my device, but once you guys do have it on your device, you want to go in the bottom left to this little Windows button, tap on that, and now search up alt server. You should see this little thing right here. Just tap on that, and you guys are probably going to notice nothing obviously popped up. However, something did actually pop up. If you guys look in the bottom right of your screen, you should see these little, like, I don't know, gray cubes. If you don't see them, tap the arrow right here and drag one of the gray cubes onto the bottom bar, just like that, with one of the gray cubes. However, I already have them right here. You should only see one. I'm gonna tap on that right there, and now it should say all this stuff. Now, guys, if you guys do want to do this, you're gonna want to actually have to plug in your iPad or iPhone into your computer right to there. So I already have mine plugged in, so I'm already good there. But if you guys do need to do that, go do that right now. But once it is plugged in, if you guys go to install all store right there, you should now see your device name right there. It is Golden's iPad in my case. So just click on that, and now you're gonna need to enter your Apple ID. Don't worry, guys, it is 100% safe. Do not worry about it. All store is very trustworthy, and all this information is basically just being sent to Apple, so no one, like, untrustworthy. And now once you guys have entered your Apple ID and password right there, hit install there, and now it should begin installing all store onto your device. Now if you guys see this pop up, hit okay right there, and now you should be good to go. And here you guys can see this is the app alt store right there. So now you're gonna want to head on over to the third ish link, maybe the fourth link, I don't know, down below. But go check that out, and it should leave you to this mega.nz file thing. But now once you guys are on this, you're gonna want to tap on download on the IPA file. Make sure you guys do open this on Safari, otherwise it's not gonna download on your device. But now it's gonna say something like this: would you like to download this? Just tap on download, guys. I promise there's no viruses or anything. I myself uploaded this file. It's 100% safe. So now you guys are just gonna want to open up the alt store app once again and go back to the my app section if you guys did not open it already. And now tap on the plus in the top left. And now you guys should not see any of these extra files, but you should see the ReKairos V16.0.1 file .IPAs. Tap on that. And now it's basically going to upload to this app store so you guys can download it. Now, because I already have it, obviously it's not going to do anything because I already have the app on my device. But do keep in mind, guys, that should hopefully work for you guys. You guys should be able to hopefully get ReKairos back on your device with Season 6 on iOS Fortnite. Now, once guys do get that on your device, I would highly recommend checking out my previous tutorial on how to actually use the app and how to set everything up. But if you guys do run into any issues, I will leave the Discord link to the owners of the ReKairos app down below. And trust me, guys, those guys will help you. They are just so nice. It really does suck that the ReKairos Zeus method did get patched or got revoked temporarily, but hopefully in the near future, it will be back. And whenever it does come back, I will be making a video for all of you guys. So you guys can be ready for that dropping very soon. But yeah, hopefully this video was at all helpful to all of you guys. And if it was, make sure you guys all go down below and smack a like on this video because it really does mean the world to me. And also, if you guys want more Fortnite mobile related content and want more updates on this entire iOS return situation, make sure you guys go down below and subscribe with those post notifications on. But either way, this has been Golden. Do with this information as you will, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.